Welcome, folks. I'm Jabby Kuwait, joined by Sintel Kuwait. We are continuing on with the final episode of Arcane from Season 1. And this episode is called The Monster You Created.
Oh, wow.
So, if you're watching this on YouTube, you're going to see a cut-down version of our reaction because we're only allowed to show you a limited amount of picture-in-picture. However, if you'd like to watch the whole thing with us, uncut, uninterrupted, head over to our Patreon page, patreon.com/JabbyKuwait. You will need your own Netflix subscription so you can open up the show in an adjacent window to our reaction, so it's like you're watching it with two of your favorite pals from the internet. If you're watching this on Patreon already, make sure to... If you're watching this on Patreon already, thanks so much for supporting us here. If you're watching this on YouTube, please hit that subscribe button, bell icon, all notifications, and vote this up to let YouTube know you're enjoying what you're watching. All right, here we go.
Poor little guy.
You didn't have a choice.
Like Mjolnir in the Thanos glove.
This is over.
Not for me.
Take those off.
Yeah, you got to come get this. Don't do it, fam.
Make me.
Really?
I can't let you leave with them.
Then I guess you're gonna need to kill another trencher.
Really? She would have whooped your ass, dude.
Thoroughly.
You won't make it alone.
She got this far.
She still got her boot thing,
though. Why are you being a bitch, dude?
Yeah, for real.
Nah, I mean, he feels bad. He killed a kid. I get it. That'll mess you up.
We still don't really fully understand how that's even made.
That was the whole, like, what do you call it, jumping off point, really, in the story of In Bruges. It's like, that'll just mess you up, you know?
Oh, this is bittersweet, man. Golly, I wanted to keep going.
Yeah. Well, I mean, we will get a season two. We just don't know when.
I wonder how long it's going to take, though. Because if they're just now greenlighting it, I would imagine, because we're talking like, what? We're talking like 4.5 hours of content. No, each one's like 45 minutes long. We're talking like close to like 8 hours of content. That's going to take a lot to animate.
Well, I don't know how they're doing this animation because it's stylistically different from traditional animation.
Right.
And so I don't know if these are like assets that are easier to work with. I have no idea how this works. I'm talking out of my ass here. I just wonder if there's a way to do it in a more succinct, compressed timeline. I don't know. As opposed to like Pixar timeline.
Right.
Been a while since Topside's gotten this bold.
I'm really surprised at how much character development she's had.
You're gonna do anything about that piece of shit that murdered my boy? Let me guess. Jinx will take care of it.
Oh, it was her boy. She's a part of the evil council, right?
Mm-hmm.
Where is Jinx anyhow?
Help her with the body.
Damn.
That's cold.
Kept it moving. He's like, that, if that's not, I told you.
Yeah, you should have had your door locked. You kind of messed up.
A little bit. You straight up dusted her. But I wonder what she unveiled.
Who's getting stronger, him or the it?
Right?
That thing.
It sounds like it's a burden, too, because it sounds heavy when it hits the ground, when his hand hits the ground. Yo, if I wish you would was a silent moment.
It seems like it's sentient.
Yeah.
Mel, would you like...
Whoa.
I can't believe you'd start a war just to cover your ass.
I would set the world ablaze to protect our family.
Damn.
I stopped being part of this family the moment you cast me out.
Because you weakened me. I couldn't endure the look in your eyes whenever I made the decisions, the necessary decisions to keep us safe.
Mm-hmm.
Let the war unfold. Then you come home, take your place at my side. It's where you belong.
She got hips.
Yeah, she do. Yeah, she do. Well, he's still sick because he still got that cane in the cough.
You thinking about jumping?
Am I interrupting?
Remember that moment they had in season one, episode one?
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Mm-hmm.
You have to destroy it, the Hex Core. I can't do it. You have to. Please.
That'll kill him.
Promise me.
It's part of him now.
Okay.
Right?
Okay. Yeah. Well, whatever that is, it's just a temporary fix. Dang, she brushed his chair off and everything.
Uh-oh.
Uh-huh. Careful.
You with him, are you?
You screwed up, Silco.
You're too young to remember what the Undercity was before it became an enterprise. We had nothing. You know what bore us through those times? Loyalty. Brothers and sisters back to back against whatever the world threw at us.
Oh, she dead.
Oh, I'm forced to share the air with parasites like you.
Hey!
Today is the day you die, Silco.
That's a risk I've known all my life. But I still believe in Luarte.
Oh, shit.
Whoa. Ooh.
That went different than I expected.
Hmm.
I thought he was gonna axe her.
Not for a worm like him.
Hmm.
But he won't be the last.
That was cool.
That was. That was really gangster. I didn't know. I didn't know how it was gonna go.
Yeah.
Blanket amnesty, unrestricted access to the Hexgate sovereignty. You really think you're in a position to demand all this?
You want peace. This is the price.
You'll discontinue the production of Shimmer, return the gemstone, and I need Jinx. She has to pay for what she's done.
Her crimes. She was working for me.
If I had it my way, it'd be you rotting in Stillwater. But we can't make a deal with a snake and cut off its head. We both have our shitty parts to play. Get me Jinx, and I'll give you your Nation of Zaun.
Ooh.
Wow. That, oh man, that's a rock and a hard place for him.
Oh man.
That's a good, what do you call it, setup?
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, how do you choose?
Your people are the one thing he really loves.
Yeah.
I'm really hoping that the two of them have that Luke Yoda thing, like he levels him up somehow.
A thousand times I've imagined this moment. Never like this. All we ever wanted. The boy didn't even haggle. And what do I lose but problems? Oh, it all makes sense now, brother.
You get what you want, but at what cost?
He's, yeah, but look at the respect that he's still giving Vander, though.
Is there anything so undoing as a daughter?
Hmm.
We still don't know what happened to girl. He thought it was about him.
Everyone out.
How many times I gotta tussle with you?
Score to settle.
Mm-hmm. You know what? I'm liking her more and more, though. She may be getting whooped, but she don't quit. I'll give her that. Round two. The Cleater. Whoa! Goodness!
Oh, shit.
They need to become friends after this, man.
Oh, shit. I didn't know you had that.
Wow, upgrades.
Whoa. What?
Woo, that was a nasty two-piece.
You gotta let that go. It's dead weight now. Get it out. Get it off.
Goodness. Oh, she remembered. Wow, I didn't think it was gonna go that way.
Yeah, me neither. Get up. Come on, get up. Oh, she's out.
Well, your guard needs work. She still needs you. They all do. So what do you say?
Oh, yeah, girl. That's what I'm talking about. Get up.
Oh.
That's my girl.
That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, we've got some equilibrium going on.
Yeah.
I didn't know it could do that.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Oh,
it double spin. Losing out.
Literally disarmed her.
You leave it behind, or you're gonna bring it.
Bravo, sis.
Oh, wow. Huh.
I'm not fit to govern the people who live there, and neither are you. Our opportunity to demonstrate our compassion has passed. They're right not to trust us.
You're walking a fine line, Jace.
Yo, he gonna give up that last council seat to him. I bet.
Silco thinks he made Jinx, but he didn't make Jinx.
You did.
You did.
Yeah.
What? Oh, she got him.
He took everything from us. Right here, he stabbed Vander in the back. Just like he planned to with me. All the time saying you abandoned me when he knew the truth. Liar. We're missing someone.
Your little girlfriend. We're Kaylinette.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
What's in the box?
I paid your girlfriend a visit this morning.
No.
What did you do?
I made her a snack.
No!
I'm not that crazy.
They had me.
Yeah.
I thought it was going to be like a seven moment.
Where should I sit? It could go away. Please. And you can have powder back.
Damn.
I can't.
The topsider has offered me everything. Independence. A seat at the table. You're my daughter. I'll never forsake you.
Drop the gun!
There's no way she's a quicker draw than Jinx.
Yeah, she knows how this is going to end.
Go!
Whoa!
Damn.
Now finish it.
Damn it.
given you to them.
I believe him too.
Yeah.
It's okay. We'll be okay.
Oh, shit.
I thought maybe you could love me like you used to. Even though I'm different, but you changed too. Here's to the new us.
I am the monster you created.
We will show them all.
I want you to lose like
I support Counselor Talis's proposal for peace.
What could have been?
Damn. Damn.
It was all good just a week ago.
Damn.
Yo. And fuck it all was a moment. Yo.
That got real dark.
Super dark. And it all worked out. That's what's crazy. It almost all worked out.
He would have had to have given her up.
But
though.
He said he wouldn't have.
Yeah, it wouldn't have worked out.
Well, they had already agreed to peace terms. Maybe they could have done it without her, without having to sacrifice. I don't know. It doesn't really even matter. The fact of the matter is she absolutely is going to destroy the council and or recreate them into, you know, versions of themselves because they had the stuff in it. We don't know if it's a bomb that totally obliterates and destroys the castle, or we don't know if it's bomb that just gases the entire place and it turns them into whatever the creatures are from the purple stuff.
It bookends, though, in a way, with the end of episode 3, because she destroyed everything. Yeah. In episode 3, and that basically set up the path and the story of, you know, the next several episodes, and so this sets up the second season. She's the most pivotal character in the show.
Yeah.
In terms of consequence and everything that happens.
Yeah.
She engineers everything that happens in this story. That's crazy.
Yeah. This whole thing, it sets an interesting stage because now that Silco's dead, we saw his number one, old girl with the arm. She's picking herself up off the ground and she's, you know, smoking a cigar. But she's in the room, the throne room. So she's probably going to run the underworld.
Silco doesn't have to be dead. We established that they were able to bring back Powder or Jinx.
I don't know, man. I think he's gone. You think he's a chance? You think he's a chance?
I don't know, man. Until he's buried.
Yeah.
I don't know. Anything could happen in this show. I really like it. I wish that it didn't end so dark, but I guess it gives you a good jumping point for season 2. It definitely had some unexpected twists and turns, to say the least. And I think that it's a beautiful show overall, between the animation style, the framing, the character development. It's all very strong. Each episode does so much episode to episode. It's like unexpected. I really like it.
Yeah.
I think this is one of the best shows I've seen, just period.
Yeah, that was the thing I was tossing. I was like, this is easily one of the best series of 2021. As far as a Netflix project goes, it's got to be a top five or maybe even a top three, because every episode was bananas. There was not a single bad episode, not one.
Yeah.
Every episode had something that it brought to the table.
The only thing I wish was that when Vi was fighting Silco's right-hand lady, mm-hmm. that they didn't cut to the outside as much, because that was being built up for a while. It felt slightly cheapened by the fact that it kept going outside. Mm-hmm. Like, we don't have to animate all of this fight scene, but like, I really wanted to see more of it. I didn't mind them cutting away, but it felt like it sort of cut the fight short in a way. Yeah. You know what I mean? I think it would have been worth exploring and allowing the episode to be another minute or two longer, but maybe there's a budgetary constraint. I mean, these 3 episodes were shorter than the previous episodes. Maybe there's a reason why they had to do that. It was a concession they had to make in order to get it done. But I thought there were some cool moments in there, and it would have just been neat to see it explored a little bit deeper, a little bit further, to see, because the concept of that fight was so neat, because these two people were like beating each other up. It wasn't just like an invincibility thing of like Leonidas against the Persians. It was like these two are both taking L's, right?
Yeah.
And it was so much fight that she had time to go get a drink.
Yeah, I like that moment. I really did like that. It's like, all right, come on, let's round two. Let's round two this bad boy.
Yeah, and it's like it was caught up in the stylistic presentation. Like, it would have been neat for, I'm of two minds about it, because I like the stylistic presentation a lot, but I think this would have been a good opportunity to go the antithesis of what we've been seeing the entire show, which is you just strip it of all the music, strip it of all the style. I mean, in terms of just like making it feel like a montage, which is what a number of the fights have been doing, this would have been a good opportunity to just slow that, take all that shit out.
Okay.
This is Vendetta.
Yeah.
Like, let's just hear the bone crunching, the contact being made. Like, let's see them go through it and get exhausted and fight. Kind of like, you know, Daredevil season one, episode two, the hallway fight.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Okay.
Let's just see it. Take out all the pizzazz. Let's just see them go at it and make it more cinematic, you know? Yeah. But it's cool. We got what we got. Yeah. That's more of a personal choice. The beats are largely the same anyway. Mm. But I liked it a lot. One of the fantastic things about this show so far is that there are consequences. Mm. Everything has consequences. These characters that died in episode three still have meaning in the final episode.
That is very true. Very true.
You don't see that very often.
No.
You know, nothing is just forgotten. Everything is very meticulous in this show, and I think it's cool. We don't know who survives at the end. We don't know what's up. A bunch of question marks. So, yeah, man.
There's two things, the two unknown whole new universes, and that is the universe of the male's mom and whatever is lurking on the other side of the mountains of what the hell do we have to defeat. I think there's that world that I'm excited about, and hopefully we'll see in season two. And I'm excited about the world about Echo and the little guy, the gizmo looking dude, what's his name, the scientist, because that scientist who has, and let's be honest, he's got like some childlike qualities. He looks like a teddy bear, and he's got this ideal of how society's supposed to be, and he gets taken down to this underground, and he sees the tree, and I think that's going to meet like this idealistic idea of how society's supposed to be based off of that. And then it'll be cool to see how that relationship broadens with Echo, because I like Echo, and I like to see what he could do with that type of guidance. So I think I'm a little really excited about those two things that we haven't really dug in deep at all. And then we still got this solid, amazing story that they've left us with at the end of season one. I think it's going to get even better.
I'm a little bit surprised that the council, that whole building, the chambers, I'm just a little surprised there's no anti-defense system there. Like, with all the tech that they've got, I'm a little bit surprised. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah.
It just seems like for as far as they've come in the past several years, you'd think that would be an imperative element. But anyway, little dude getting axed from the council and, you know, going to the underground with Echo. Mm-hmm. That turned out to be a blessing in disguise, because his ass would have gotten hit first by that missile.
Sure would have. Let me ask you a question. Know? Let me see if you've noticed it. There's always been an open seat. There's always been one open seat every time, because they'll take these pans and they'll show you all the councilmen, and there's always an open seat that's available. And I've always been wondering, I've noticed for like the past like two or three episodes, I'm like, somebody's going to fill that seat. And what I thought was going to happen, I thought Silco was going to take that seat. I thought that was going to be the thing, that they'll have a seat at the table, and then all of them will get together. And then they really switched it on me, and they was like, nah, we're just going to give them just all complete independence. Did you notice the additional seat that was just chilling there, or like?
Yeah, it belonged to dude. It belonged to the little guy.
But I thought Jace took little guy's seat.
Jace had his own seat for a hot second before he kicked off little
guy. Oh, okay, then there you go. There you go. Yeah. So there was a legitimate open seat then.
Because it was traditionally seven seats or something like that on the council. Yeah. And then, you know, Jace coming into play, you know, installs an eighth seat, but then it goes back to seven when they kick out the dude. Okay. So I really like the show a lot. I think it's so dope and so creative, and it's so unexpected. This isn't what I thought I was going to get when I heard about this. Looking forward to what they got in store for season two, and hopefully it comes sooner than later. All right, you guys, thanks so much for hanging out. Please hit that subscribe button, bell icon, all notifications, and vote this up to let YouTube know you enjoyed what you watched. If you're watching this on YouTube, if you're watching it on Patreon, thanks so much for supporting us here. Make sure to follow Sintel on his YouTube channel, youtube.com/Sintel, and also on Instagram, Sintel, @Sintel. That's it for now. Thanks so much, guys. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. I'm Jabby Koi. This is
It's your boy.
Peace out.